Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video where I will be discussing very important questions for your RBI SEBI NABARD phase 1 current affairs, as well as these questions can be of use if you are appearing for banking PO exams. So let's begin this video, but before that, if you are a newcomer here, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. You can join this Telegram group by the link given in the description below. And the benefit of joining this Telegram group is that you will get to enjoy the free quizzes that we provide, and you will also get the latest updates about the exams or about the new updates provided by the RBI SEBI NABARD related to the examination. So these kinds of updates are provided on this Telegram channel. This is the RBI Gravy 2022 course, guys, where you will get PDFs, videos and mocks. Along with all these things, you will also get assistance for your phase 3, that is interviews. And this is the booklet that you will get if you enroll in this new course. And this booklet contains all the books mentioned in the slide here. This is the 30% discount that we are running on this course right now. You can avail this 30% discount by using the RBI30 coupon code. And this is the number which you can dial if you want to have any queries, if you want to get your queries resolved, and if you find any kind of difficulty in understanding the eligibility criteria or anything related to the examination, then you can just call on this number and get it resolved. Here is the first question. Indian Coast Guard has been conducting Operation Olivia every year since the early 1980s to protect olive ridley turtles as they congregate along the Dash Coast. So in which state do these olive ridley turtles congregate? Now, what is the purpose of their congregation? The purpose is to lay eggs, to nest their eggs. That is the purpose. That is why they congregate along the Odisha coast. So here the answer is option C. So this Indian Coast Guard deploy its assets like its patrol vessels and another kind of offshore vessels in order to protect the olive ridley turtles. Now understand this thing, that what is the reason behind launching this Operation Olivia, that too by the Indian Coast Guard. The reason behind the endangeredness of these olive ridley turtles. They are considered vulnerable in the list of IUCN. So they are categorized as vulnerable in IUCN's red list. They are also present in the Schedule 1st of Indian Wildlife Protection Act 1972. They are also in the Appendix 1st of the list of sites, which prohibits their trade among different countries as well as among the individuals. So these are the lists that mention the vulnerable and endangered animals in the world. And here, the olive ridley turtle is present in all these three lists. So this highlight in itself how endangered this species is. Now guys, remember that it comes to the shore when it has to lay its egg, and the breeding is offshore. So breeding is done in the sea itself, but they come ashore to lay their egg, and their nesting habits are quite unique in the natural world. Whenever they nest in the mass population, then that is called Eribidas. So Eribidas is the name given to the process of mass nesting by these olive ridley turtles. So I guess that was all that you need to know about this olive ridley turtle. Yes, I remember that there was a recent discovery of a new nesting site of these olive ridley in Andaman and Nicobar. So remember, recently in Andaman and Nicobar, a new nesting site of these olive ridley turtles has been found, and this can become a probable question in your examination. So that was all about this question. My question from you is that you have to tell me, when was this CITES treaty adopted for the protection of endangered species? So that is your task. Tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, which of the following is the proposed mission of European Space Agency for Venus? Venus Express, Cassini, Akatsuki, Envision, Venera. So these are the options. Out of these options, the right answer is option D, Envision. So this Envision is expected to be launched by 2030s. Why 2030s? Because the year has not been decided yet. It is expected to be launched by 2030, and 2031 is expected to be the earliest date for its launch. Now, European Space Agency has partnered with NASA to launch this mission, and NASA is going to provide a radar for this spacecraft named as Envision, and this radar is going to help this spacecraft in mapping the surface of Venus. Now, what is the exact purpose for launching Envision? First purpose is to understand the atmospheric properties of Venus. That is very obvious. That is the basic purpose for launching any mission to the other planet. But what is the core reason for launching this mission? The core reason is to understand the difference in Earth and Venus. Both of them look alike. Then what is the difference that Venus became the hottest planet of the solar system? Why Earth can sustain life whereas Venus cannot? The reason behind this increased curiosity in the planet of Venus is the recent discovery of phosphine gas. Guys, this is a gas that is released due to the biological processes. And recently, traces of this gas has been found in the atmosphere of Venus that has increased the curiosity of scientists in the planet of Venus. So there is a question whether there was a life on Venus or not. And if that life was there, then how did Venus become the hottest planet that it is shrouded with the clouds of carbon? And can Earth become the same like Venus? Will the future of Earth be the same like Venus? Because Earth is also heating and the carbon is also accumulating in the atmosphere. So is there any chance that in the future ahead of us, in the 1,000-2,000 years, can Earth also become like Venus, where the entire atmosphere is clouded with the clouds of carbon? So that is the main question that is going to be answered through this Envision mission. So basically, that is to discover the atmospheric and the terrestrial properties of Venus and to understand how these two planets are different and how can Earth be prevented from becoming another Venus. So that is the reason. Now, recently, NASA has also announced two missions for Venus, and they are also going to study the terrestrial properties as well as the atmospheric properties of Venus. So the one mission is Da Vinci Plus and Veritas. So these are the two missions that NASA has announced to launch during 2028 to 2030. So again, this increased curiosity is due to the discovery of this phosphine gas. So earlier, I would say in last week only, NASA has announced these missions, and following the footsteps of NASA, ESA has announced this mission for Venus. So that was all about this question. Now my question from you is that who is the chief of NASA? Who is the chief administrator of NASA? Mention it in the comment section below. So third question is, which institute has produced a 10 episode series on various aspects of common yoga protocol, which would be telecast on DD India at 7 p.m. from today till the 21st of this month. Okay, so first let me tell you what is the special day on 21st of this month. On 21st of this month, we celebrate International Yoga Day, and this would be the 7th version of this day, 7th edition of International Yoga Day. So this is the 10 episode series. Now, which institute has launched this series? You have Indian Institute of Yoga and Naturopathy, Central Council for Research in Yoga and Naturopathy, the Yoga Institute Delhi, Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga, All India Naturopathy and Yoga Education Council. So which of these institutes has launched this series? The right answer here is option D, that is Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga. Now guys, remember that Ministry of Ayush and this Morarji Desai Institute have together organized a curtain raiser event for this 7th edition of this International Yoga Day. And during that event, they launched an application named Namaste Yoga. This application is going to increase the awareness about yoga, and it is going to promote yoga at the community level. So that is the purpose of launching this Namaste Yoga application. And I hope that this is clear to you. Now I am moving on to the next question. Which state has received GI tag for Jardalu mangoes? So we have Bihar, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Odisha. Out of these options, Bihar is the right answer. So Bhagalpur is the area which received the GI tag for Jardalu mangoes in the year 2018. You are amazed, right? When this Jardalu mangoes got the GI tag in 2018, then why are we discussing it at the present moment? The reason behind this is that the first ever consignment, commercial consignment for these Jardalu mangoes has been sent from Bihar to UK. So that is the reason these Jardalu mangoes are in the news. Now, I hope that this is reminding you of Shahi Lychee as well. That was in the news some time back. So Shahi Lychee is another product from Bihar that has got GI tag in 2018 only. But it was also exported to United Kingdom. So remember, the Jardalu mangoes and Shahi lychee. Now, apart from these two products, there are other two products as well in Bihar that have got the GI tag. So these four products are the GI tag products in Bihar. So what are those two other products? The third product is Madhai Pan and Katarni rice. So these are the four products that have got GI tag from Bihar. And Shahi lychee and Jardalu mangoes are in the news because they were exported to United Kingdom. So this was also a hint to you guys, because similar question was asked from you in your recent RBI grade day examination when there was a question on Kala Namak rice. So Kala Namak rice was in the news because it was exported to Singapore after a long period of time. I would say the first time the Kala Namak rice was exported to Singapore. And remember, this Kala Namak rice got the GI tag back in the year 2012. But since, because of its export, it was in the news, therefore a question came in your RBI grade examination. Therefore, you are required to keep your eyes open to such kind of news. Particularly the NABARD students, you have to pay a special attention to the products that are GI tagged and that are exported to other countries. Now, do you know that under which act this GI certification is given to the products? So the act is Geographical Indication of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999 is the act under which the goods are given GI certification. So I hope you can remember the information that I have provided you so far. And now let's move on to the next question. Okay, so this is again about European Space Agency's new project. So European Space Agency has planned to launch the world's first wooden satellite, VESA Woodset, on Earth's orbit by the end of 2021. The mission will test the applicability of wooden materials like plywood in spacecraft structures and expose it to extreme space conditions such as heat, cold, vacuum and radiation for an extended period of time. The satellite will be launched on a Rocket Lab Electron rocket from the Mahaya Peninsula Launch Complex. In which country is the complex located? So here the long question is asking you about the Mahaya Peninsula at the last. So first of all, let us understand the answer of this question. Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg, New Zealand, Croatia are in the options, out of which New Zealand is the right answer. So this Mahaya Peninsula is located in New Zealand. So this WoodSat satellite will be launched from New Zealand. Remember this thing, this is a very important fact, apart from this, that this is the world's first wooden satellite. I hope that this is ringing a bell in your minds that why is this world's first wooden satellite when we already have heard about Japan launching the world's first wooden satellite. So here the demarcation is that European Space Agency has announced to launch it by the end of 2021, whereas Japan has announced to launch the world's first wooden satellite by the year 2023. So if this European Space Agency succeeds in launching this satellite, then the accolade of launching the world's first wooden satellite would go to European Space Agency. Now the next thing of importance is the name of this satellite, VESA satellite, WoodSat. Okay, remember this name. The third important point here is the name of the rocket, Rocket Lab Electron rocket, on which this satellite will be launched. Remember the fourth point here of importance is that Finland has developed this satellite. Basically, Finland is in charge of developing this wooden satellite. So that was all about this entire question. I hope that this is comprehensible to you. And if you have any kind of query or confusion between Japan or this mission, then you can ask me in the comment section below. Now you would be thinking, what is the need of launching wooden satellite? Why European Space Agency and Japan are announcing the missions to launch wooden satellite? The reason is the space junk, because the satellites are created from the metals. Therefore, the space junk is increasing because they cannot be decomposed. They are not decomposing. They are just adding into the space junk. But if the wooden satellite becomes feasible, then the space junk would be reduced because wood is combustible and it can be removed from the space junk. So that is the whole purpose of this satellite. Now guys, can you tell me the chief of this European Space Agency? So I have asked you chiefs of two space agencies, NASA and European Space Agency. So do tell me in the comment section below. The next question is, who will deliver the 17th Royal Prebysh Lecture at UN Trade Forum 2021? First of all, this UN Trade Forum was held in Geneva, Switzerland. And what was the theme of this forum? The theme was towards a green and inclusive recovery. So that was the theme of this UN Trade Forum. Now, this Royal Prebysh Lecture is the annual event. This is basically an event that is held every year in this UN Trade Forum. And this is nothing but a lecture that is offered by prominent individuals at the UN Trade Forum. And this year is the 17th edition of it, which is going to be offered by Esther Duflo. And she is the Nobel Laureate in Economics. Now, remember that she is at present a professor at Massachusetts Institute of Technology in US. And she is also a co-founder of a very important organization. The name of that organization is your task to find out and tell me in the comment section below. So that was all about this question. Now, this is the time to say goodbye to each other. Thank you so much.